topic today is building and nurturing a local open source community. Some of the opening remarks were essentially to talk a little bit about building the local community, building, working with students, working with the campuses. So we'll go ahead and building and nurturing. So something in common. Any idea? What am I talking about? Okay. So a few months ago, a few people met. Some of them were developers. Some were DevOps. Some were working on PHP, JavaScript. Some were designers. Some were team leads. Some were working in the government. This is a photo from the WordPress coaching meetup. So what they actually have in common is WordPress. They come from different things, they have different ideas, they have different backgrounds, they have different cultural backgrounds, some have different life skills, professional skills, but they all come together to essentially discuss, talk, and share about how they are using WordPress. That coming together itself is the community. And what happens is some of these people meet over and over again, become friends, start to collaborate, and start to get ideas. Ideas on how to take that message to 14, like hundreds of people, like this word again. Something similar happened last year, which was a meeting, offered meeting up all the time, becomes a word again, like a conference. What is interesting is we know now what the community is. It's a meetup that becomes a word camp. It's a group of people coming together, discussing WordPress. But how do we get there? How do we build a community? What should we do to actually create a community? So one of the first advice I would give you is to make space and include everyone. So usually lions are photographed as in a single lion is photographed. So there are three lions, so making space for each other. The idea is to make space for everybody. Try not to convert your meetups, try not to convert your community into a user base. Try not to capitalize it into a business, and try to keep it more open source friendly and make sure that it belongs to everybody. Explore and navigate together. So first part is it belongs to everybody, but then what happens next? We need to explore and navigate WordPress together. Try to find your way. So in the community, what happens is there is no straightforward paths. We have like a lighthouse, and essentially you have to find your own way to the lighthouse. The lighthouse could be anything, becoming a WordPress expert, becoming a WordPress for contributors or something like that. So it's something the community allows you to explore and navigate together rather than doing it all by yourself or self-learning, etc. You can get mentors, you can get mentorships, and you can So, also thirdly, think of your community as a bit of a public library where you can learn, teach, and share knowledge. When I say public library, it means that the place that is public, but it has rules. You can't talk loudly, you can't play music there, but it also has, it's also a place that's accessible to everybody, regardless of backgrounds, gender, and other things. So, and finally, you have to create a safe place that allows people to congregate together, share things. This is very important because somewhere down the line, people who have come together, there is a large group of people who will not show up if the place doesn't seem to be a safe place. The people are trolling each other or people are making fun of each other, especially about their knowledge or about their skill set, then it's not a safe place. So a good idea is to create a safe place where people can keep going. For a local community, it's always a good idea to have a regular meetup at a regular place, at a regular time. That works best. That works best for any community, even if it's like a video game community. That's it. Any questions?
Question is about the thing, very personal, individual. So how can an individual benefit or prosper as, from being part of a community?
So
specifically WordPress community.
So WordPress is, so this is my personal journey into WordPress. I strongly believe in the because of open source, but I'm not a developer. I did not use Linux. So, and a lot of the open source communities are centered around Linux. You have to know how to use a terminal. I learned that after joining WordPress. But the thing is that you could actually meet content writers, you could meet designers, you could meet people from very different backgrounds. For using this open source software, if they get involved in the community, they could be introduced to the open source ideas or philosophy to take ahead and actually share it in different ways than just about the developers who share code. That's all.
Hi, Aditi. My question, I just want to revisit your speech actually. Could you please elaborate on the portion where you said please make sure you don't use them as a user's, user base. When you say about, specifically talk about the community.
So when I say when you're building a community in the WordPress community, do not try to use it as a user base, as in do not try to recruit, do not try to sell your product. You can talk about your product. And talk about what you know as a developer, as a person who has freelance or whatever. But so the point is to share what you know rather than try to gain users or you know customers, sales, things like that. Because once that happens, it's a one-way discussion of one person or two people with an entire user base, and it's no longer a community, it's a term. So the community essentially has to be people who can, community survives individuals and that's over everyone. So if you try to avoid creating a user base out of the community, so that will survive. If you're not interested anymore, you keep someone out.
Thank you. One follow-up question, please. Thank you. How do you think a community can grow? I mean, WordPress is a developing community, and we know WordPress is one of the vibrant communities among the whole world communities. So please share your thoughts on how the community can grow.
Yeah, so it's something I can actually talk for hours about, but there are some things that any community has to do, which is what I spoke about very briefly. So those are really basic guiding points, but one of the main things is to meet regularly, to meet in person. There are online communities, obviously, but the reason we have offline communities and we ask meetups to meet regularly offline is that people actually connect with other people, and that sort of helps people, or helps the community to grow, or helps the group to grow. And yes, you have to include everybody. So for instance, if I ask everybody who's part of the WordPress